Stony Brook University Medical Center has a very unique program for the evaluation of acute chest pain in the emergency room, which is different from most other hospital emergency rooms in the United States. When a patient with acute chest pain comes to the emergency room, we get one set of blood tests to exclude the possibility of acute myocardial infarction or heart attack, and an EKG to show that the patient is not having a heart attack. If both the tests are negative, the patient will go to the cardiac CT protocol, where we will check their blood tests for kidney function, and if the kidney function is normal, we will proceed with giving the patient medication to prepare the patient for the cardiac CT. And the CT will be done very quickly, within an hour or so, and once the test is performed and is negative, the patient will be sent home shortly afterward.
Implementing coronary computed tomography angiography has really transformed how we treat people with chest pain. One of the hardest decisions to make is who should be admitted, who doesn't need to be admitted when people present with chest pain. And in the past, we admitted lots of people who had low risk, but we weren't sure because you have diagnostic uncertainty. And about 5% of those people would end up having myocardial infarction, or they'd have, you know, real disease. The difficulty is knowing which one out of that 20 that person is. It's been very difficult over time to figure that out. And this is where the CT angiography of the coronary arteries is so powerful, because it allows real-time imaging of obstructed or non-obstructed coronary arteries, and you have the knowledge to act with confidence.
We went through a transition last year. We've been using a 64 slice since 2009, when I first joined Stony Brook. And in April of 2010, we added the 320 slice volume scanner. And we've been collecting data from its inception. And what we found is something very interesting. We found that we have dramatically reduced the amount of IV contrast used per patient, about 50%. And also the radiation dose, we have reduced it significantly, about 50%. And with the 320 volume scanner, we have a lot more room to be able to handle more challenging cases, such as patients who may not be able to breath hold for a long period of time, and patients whose heart rate may be a little bit erratic. And the volume scanner really gives us a lot of freedom to do more cases more quickly.
As new health reform laws start to get implemented, one of the overriding goals is to improve quality and to get feedback to everybody in the community, the insurers, the patients, and to be more effective and to cost less. So there's great avenues here, because in our experience, it's reduced the number of admissions for people with chest pain. The patients have some knowledge if they're coming in because they're afraid they're having a heart attack, and they have the CT angiography, they know with the result. Do they have obstructions? Are the obstructions significant that need treatment, or are they non-obstructive? And then we search for another cause of their symptoms. I think it's going to play a big role, because it has the potential to reduce the need for hospitalization, and it also has, for large numbers of people, and to find the ones who actually do need to be hospitalized and have a procedure done.
Being part of a large academic center, research on outcomes and cost effectiveness was one of our concerns in implementing this program. In the past, in 2008 and prior, of all of our chest pain patients that presented in the emergency department, 50% of those were admitted. So we have saved a number of unnecessary admissions. And by our calculations, we estimate for every 250 patients that are not admitted, the medical center saves approximately $1.5 million.